way that you can defeat the enemy without being empowered.
If we are going to come to the point of harvesting with God, we must prepare the ground. We must plow.
God is the sovereign God, and God is above everything.
How many people have you met, but you have done nothing to those people? Kakuhlale phansi ubuze kule ndawo usebenza kuyo kubani okhe wakulandela. Because the Holy Spirit, where you are, he's got a potential to produce fruit that other people, they envy it. People begin to say, tell me. I've been watching and observing you. Your character. Because the Holy Spirit builds up your character. A number of people, they really envy a good character. Even if they don't say that. Now, we go back. And he said, the spirit of the womb, the world cannot receive and take it to its head because it does not see him or know him. But you know him because he, the Holy Spirit, remains with you continually and he will be with you. I will not leave you as orphans, comfortless, bereaved, helpless. I will come back to you. After a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me. Because I live, you will also live. I get to glory. Jagba epila uyesu owayelapha emhlabeni ezisenyameni. Siphila nalo Yesu ngenxa kaMoya oNgcwele. The Holy Spirit lives in us. I've come to introduce Moya oNgcwele, the leader of the church, again. And we'll continue to do that almost ngokuside siqinise ukuba nani nizawufundisa abanye, but there's only one leader of the church, is the Holy Spirit. And until you become convicted as an individual, it has got nothing to do in a scholar. Because even if you are still conscious about the scholar, sacred, everything, because you are so called, 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 that rich man was very rich. But Lazarus was not comforted here. He had to go to be with the Lord and was comforted in Abraham's bosom. That's true. You know what? That's not it. It's done as a commerce and everything. So for deal. Was made money. Well, Lazarus, the Bible does not say he was eating. He would wish. But he was, while he was still crawling, the dogs came and licked his wounds. That's the comparison that we must have. Never utwali status sakwa sizunqeda. Praise God. Hallelujah. Now, the Bible says that on that day when that time comes, you will know for yourselves that I am in the Father and you are in me and I am in you. Now, let's go to Acts. This is our teaching part. So that lunchtime, we go for lunch. Leaders are here. And the leaders, we need to go back and embrace the leader of the church. We cannot lead without the leader of the church. We need to partner with the leader of the church. Acts chapter 1, verse 5. For John baptized with water, but you will be baptized and empowered and united with the Holy Spirit not long from now, speaking to his disciples. He said empowered and united with the Holy Spirit. It means there's going to be a partnership. And John did that. He baptized with water. But you will be baptized and empowered. Somebody say empowered. And not only empowered and united with the Holy Spirit. Not long from now. So verse 6, so when they had come together, they asked him repeatedly, Lord, are you at this time re-establishing the kingdom and restoring it to Israel? He said to them, it is not for you to know the times and or epochs which the Father has fixed by his own authority, but you will receive power. You will receive power. You will receive power and ability when the Holy Spirit comes upon you. You're going to receive power. You're going to receive ability. The enablement. You will be able to do what I've instructed you. When he comes. And then he begins to say, no, but, and you will be my witnesses. In other words, tell people about me, both in Jerusalem, Judea, and Samaria, and even to the ends of the earth. And this is the work of the Holy Spirit. It's nothing else. Let me say this outright. You can never fake the Holy Spirit. Because the Holy Spirit does not demand your flesh to show a case or put your flesh up front. And yena landele. You submit to him and he begins to produce the fruit that in the corner. Amen. You are not going to say, Tina, I've heard a lot of people, but yeah, Barcelona, Barcelona, baby. That is why it can be very difficult for you. I mean, let me not say difficult. It cannot be easy for you to lie when the Holy Spirit lives in you. Let me put it in another version. When you are sensitive to this partner who is in you. Because sometimes you begin to be insensitive to the one whom we have claimed that is a leader. And you begin to suppress or and I'm going to imagine indlela ivakalelo yethu uvele bazi mayingcola kaloxelekwe. He does not speak loud. He does not enforce himself. He whispers very gently and say, no, it's not right. And he said, when are you going to say it's right? And anything that comes from the evil one, it's pushy. It says, do it now. Quickly. quickly, just do it now. And the Holy Spirit does not work like that. He has got that still voice that in the background he'll say, but this is not going to be good for you. That's exactly what we are demanded to go. We need to go back to that still, to that small voice. Look on, Ugqaphu kodubulo. Oluzawuba khona. Into na xa sibuyele enyanini. When we begin to go back, when we become sensitive again to the Holy Spirit, when we begin to submit, when we begin to be obedient to the Holy Spirit. flesh and blood will never inherit the kingdom of God. Let me warn us here. Nabungathanda nje uzipaint usijika jike uthini wenze make over ncumisa ube sisiphithi phithi esithilwe uxakeke aw mhla kwathwa mayitshona yatshona baphinde napha emojwana ba upaint ba kupaint siphinde sikujikeleze sikhale hi ukuba bona abantu xa bejonga umuntu ebhokisini akekho uphumile umuntu wakwenyana uhambile uzawushiyeka lo. The truth is that flesh and blood will never inherit the kingdom of God. Masixakekise le nyama isincedise sisebenze into kaThixo. Sivumele umoya ingcoloza umkanathi ongazushiya naphakade. Now you will receive power and the ability when the Holy Spirit comes and upon you, and you will be my witnesses to tell people about me, both in Jerusalem. I've said that. So the Holy Spirit, we understand that, is for power and ability to be able to do the mission and the plan of God. Now, to have fellowship with the Holy Spirit is not just going around and claiming that I'm have the Holy Spirit. It's a partnership. It is to communicate with him and to be actively involved in a relationship with him. These things, I mean, God made these things to become practical. You don't have a religion, kanga, of relationship with faith. Uti, dinale religion, nobody, I'm tired of faith, I'm going to enter. I still reminded the HMN. Then they want us to a conference. I'm going to go to the HMN. I'm going to go to the HMN. Because a relationship is a relationship. Even people when they say, when we accepted Jesus Christ as our personal savior, but as our personal savior, but in him, Kenyan, about Mamma and Lola. Heard you all? Oh, my God. And I attend you in Abazan, I attend to Salek, I'm a summer garden. Okay, about Mosh about it. Oh, yes, when you name Kenyan, it won't pack at you. Because it's a relationship. And but so we need to understand, maybe where we're coming from, we never had a relationship. But it's the time, because we teach you as couples how to relate with your spouses, those who are married. And those who are not married, you relate with your parents. It's not a religion. If you have a father, you have a mother, you don't have a religion. And then they will stand in the corner, and you're going to be talking, no, Dada, okay. Ticela undithengele. Because a relationship, it's wherever you go, you say, Holy Spirit, you are my friend. Holy Spirit, I love you. Holy Spirit, I can do nothing without you. Holy Spirit, you are my friend. Holy Spirit, if I'm going to, I have a problem with this thing, and the Holy Spirit will begin to drop some thoughts. You know, wisdom, you don't have to be, wisdom, and go, okay, Lord. As a person speaks, you submit to the Holy Spirit, and he begins to interpret and tell you exactly how you should respond. if in our relationships, marriage relationships, we were like that, were sensitive enough not to just respond and hurt your partner. Ukumamela lapha kumoya ngcwele, le nto ndizayithetha, is it not going to hurt her? And begin to say, Holy Spirit, how am I supposed to respond to her? You know how hurting it is when you relate with somebody. Oof, ba lendo aiteta ikana ikling ba isam katas. Ukalu kugena njenglo nda uvelu katas zega ba uba. Intol mato njenga ikana ikling ba lendo yansupa. I don't know even how to respond to this, because it's never coming from a person who gave it a thought that it's going to put me in a blind spot. And even difficult for me to respond. That's a relationship. We hate each other, even if you are not married, in cell groups, in wherever you go. We would never have people who just want to sleep with a person when you have not married that person, when you really have the Holy Spirit, when you are sensitive to the Holy Spirit. Uvela ufuke nje uqonde ba ujonge lo mntu umhalele uvela ubone ba ungasikulale naye, but awuzubana commitment after that. Because when you marry somebody, you marry that person for companionship, first and foremost. Because as zinto uzinqwenelayo apha kuye zisenongaphasi kakuhle apha ehambeni. Uba kwakufuneka engumntu opasayo mhlawumbe ebhedini aphelelwe inyama le, kodwa shiyeke nomoya kaThixo. Oh, not too long. When my colors are great, when my colors are interesting, I call it. Color is cool. I need a couple of money here.